Hello everyone, this is Neil Davis from Digital Cloud Training. People often ask me about AWS exam dumps. It's a very popular question that I get asked all the time. In this video, I want to talk about why I believe that you should absolutely avoid exam dumps as much as possible. Now, I previously wrote an article about this, and it's on our website. You'll find the link in the description of this video. Now, that was a very popular article, and in it, I discuss why I think it's a bad idea to go and look at exam dumps. So check out that article as well, but in this video, I'm going to talk about that very topic. So firstly, what are exam dumps? Well, an exam dump is essentially where somebody has taken the real exam material from an exam, like an Amazon Web Services exam, and they're sharing it somewhere on the internet or potentially selling it to you. Now, they get that through various means. I don't know exactly how they do it, but they get the real exam questions probably from an exam center. Maybe they memorize them. But either way, whatever they do, they end up dumping those on the internet. So a lot of people think, well, that's great then. That's a great study tool. If I know the answers to those questions, then when I go into the exam, I'm going to pass my exam. Now, the problem is, firstly, I really think that you should absolutely know the subject matter yourself. When you go into your exam, it's not just about passing the exam. If you want to get a job or a promotion in the cloud industry, you need to know what you're doing on the job. So there's really no substitute for getting lots of training and really some practical skills as well. Another factor is often these exam dumps will have the incorrect answer specified and maybe even a very misleading explanation, but usually none at all. So that means it can push you off track and you still got to understand the subject matter yourself to determine the correct answer. Now, another thing is the exam will change over time. So AWS will introduce new questions to the exam. So you cannot guarantee that just by learning and memorizing the answers to questions that you've seen somewhere that you're going to be able to pass the exam, because AWS do change the exam pool, new questions come up, even variations to existing questions. So if you don't really understand the subject matter, you're going to fail. So those are a few reasons why I highly recommend that you always avoid exam dumps. Even as a reference material, they can just be misleading, and I would suggest that you ignore them completely. The better thing to do is to go to a training provider who provides high quality courses. You'll need a video-based course. You'll need a practice test course where the practice questions actually simulate the real exam questions. For instance, our questions on Digital Cloud Training website are extremely similar, but not the same as the real questions. That means you get a very strong idea of what types of questions are being asked, what the various bits of knowledge are you need to know before you sit your exam, and it gives you a gauge of how close you are to being ready to pass your exam as well, so that you don't try and take it too early. We also have cheat sheets as well, which are a really great way of getting to the core facts that you need to know for the exam in a more summarized way, because in some courses there really is a lot of subject matter to learn. So really, there's no substitute for learning. You don't want to cheat your way through an exam. You want to actually go in there. And really, personally, I feel so much better if I put in the hard work and I go into my exam and I don't just pass it, but I feel really confident as well. Then I'll come out and I'll feel better about going out into the world and using those skills because I know I've got them and I've got validation from AWS as well. So I hope that helps. And if you like this video, please click the like button below. And don't forget to subscribe to our channel to get more updates on AWS certification.